गुड मॉर्निंग, माय नेम प्रोफेसर सुनील अग्रवाल। आई एम इन्वेंटर ऑफ अग्रवाल एनर्जी कॉन्सेप्ट एंड कलर थेरेपी। नाउ आई एम ट्राइंग टू रीडिफाइन द चाइनीज टीसी मेरिडियन विद द हेल्प ऑफ द कलर और विद द हेल्प ऑफ द अग्रवाल एनर्जी कॉन्सेप्ट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू पीपल अबाउट द सिज़ोफ्रेनिया। Schizophrenia is a disease, is a neuro disease, mental disorder or problem related with the brain. But in my experience, I have treated so many patients of schizophrenia, I found it out, this problem is related with the digestive system. Those people who were suffering from severe constipation throughout the life, they were found most affected by this schizophrenia disease. Schizophrenia disease, how it affect to the brain and what is the link between the digestive system and the brain? I will try to explain, and this video will be in two parts. One part will be explanation, what is the schizophrenia and how it is related with the brain and the digestive system. In large intestine, everybody know there are harmful bacteria and useful bacteria. Those bacteria which are harmful for the digestive system, they create the constipation in the body and they create the skin allergy in the body. They create asthmatic issue, they create breathing related, constipation, skin and so many other energy related issue, because large intestine and lungs are the organ which is receiver of the heavenly energy. Whatever heavenly energy is received by the brain, there is a point where we used to keep the shikha or we used to keep the choti. Now in tiny meridian they call this point DU20 or in yoga Sahasrara chakra. When this chakra is not able to receive the cosmic energy and this energy directly related with the digestive system or Muladhar chakra or Swadhisthana chakra is the receiver of the entire energy in the body and it's a controller of the energy with the help of the pituitary gland. Once there is any part of the body is not working properly or not behaving properly, immediately our pituitary gland passes on the circle to the direction to the Swadhisthana chakra. That organ is underactive, that organ is overactive, please control them. Swadhisthana chakra react in that manner and it control and it direct the system to the body or organ to the body to behave in a proper manner. Now I was talking about the large intestine, harmful bacteria. Harmful bacteria is having the amoeba, small amoeba and the small x of the amoeba. Or the bacteria, that bacteria when they mix up in the blood and they mix up in the blood and it goes in the circulatory system and nervous system of the body and it enter in the brain. Once they enter in the brain, they try to sedate the brain or they affect the brain, they slow down the membrane, slow down the working of the brain. So this is the directly related with the how this schizophrenia is related with the digestive system and the brain. That I try to justify you people and I hope you people maybe understand. In case any patient is suffering from the schizophrenia, the first step is to test a stool, do the stool culture and do the as possible as many tests of the stool. So that you can, there is a EH, Stoka, Stolia amoeba, that you can diagnose in the medical report. If that bacteria or that amoeba is found in the large intestine, then it is a root cause of that problem. And if that root cause is treated very easily, your schizophrenia patient can be treated. Thank you so much. Wait for my next video. In this context, I will discuss how this can be treated. Thank you.